Welcome to the Guide for Advanced Shark Diving, lesson number 4, adapting your freediving.
Go scuba dive with sharks, you can go freediving with sharks, swimming, snorkeling, but we're going to specifically talk about freediving and adapting that. So as a professional freediver, oftentimes you'll just tuck your head down and go straight down in one direction, which, as you should know, turning constantly and looking around constantly is like lesson number 1 practically for how to be more like a predator and be treated more like a predator. And so unlike just strictly freediving, you want to continually move and scan all directions, which starts on the surface. So before actually diving down, you'd want to swim forward quietly without creating any kind of splashing on the surface, because splashing on the surface is going to draw attention towards you. And so you want to move forward slowly without splashing as you're scanning left, right, directly in front of you. And when you first tuck your head to go down into the water column, you'll actually crane your neck up and check directly in front of you to make sure that you didn't miss a shark that's approaching perhaps with the swells or just outside your peripheral. And so what you'll do is, instead of dropping down straight down, you'll just drop down maybe 5 to 10 feet, and then you're going to turn and you're gonna check all directions. Now, if you're only dropping down to 5 or 10 feet, you're really close to the surface. And so your body's naturally gonna wanna float up. And so unlike just strictly professional freediving, you're actually gonna want to overweight yourself a little bit. Now, not so much that you're sinking and you can't breathe, but you wanna wear a weight belt that has significantly more weight so that you could actually kick yourself up in the water and sink straight down and scan your peripheral. And what that's doing is allowing you to get deeper in the water in a vertical position. Because when you're vertical, you're less likely to be treated more like a marine mammal. So marine mammals are generally swimming horizontal. So when you're vertical in the water, your head is closer to the surface, you're not exposing your neck the way that you do when you go head first. So overweighting also allows you to do a normal head first dive, minimizing splashing, because all you need to do is sort of turn your fins up into the air and then glide down. And then dropping down to 5 or 10 feet, depending on what species you're working with and where you're at in the world, if the sharks are close to the surface, you're generally gonna stay close to the surface. And this allows your center of gravity to be around your hips or around your core, and you're able to turn quite rapidly because you have this extra weight to sort of leverage against. Whereas if you were underweighted and you're kind of floating on the surface, it's harder to actually have that field of vision or to get down and respond. So if you have a shark that's approaching you or people that you're guiding, if you have a shark that's approaching you very, very closely, you wanna be able to maintain your position in the water column, which is very difficult to do if you don't have ample weighting or a sufficient amount of weight on your weight belt. So adapting your freediving gear, especially the weight belt, is pretty key. Adapting it to coloring, and then adapting the way that you're moving in the water so that you're continually turning.
Good form for freediving, you know, is putting the hands above the head and locking in more of an arrow shape kind of, and not looking around as much. So we're gonna avoid pretty much all of that. We wanna kind of streamline approach into the water, especially on a dive. Be aware of where the sharks are in proximity to you. But the form you're gonna use is a little bit different. As you're going down, you know, if I have my camera, I'm still gonna break and use to pinch my nose. But as I'm vertical in the water, and this is down going up, I'm gonna be looking around, you know, like this on my dive, as well as looking up or looking in my direction I'm diving to. But then also even glancing back at my feet and seeing where the surface is. And that way I can kind of see if there's any activity at the surface. So again, just trying to get as much vision in as possible on your dive. And when you're going down the turn, it's important that you come up and you're vertical instead of just like staying horizontal at the bottom. You want to always have that vertical position because you look like a bigger animal in the water. And if a shark is swimming at you and you're still kind of swimming in this direction, if you face it like this, vertical in the water, all of a sudden that shark sees that you're a lot bigger than you appeared to be. And so that kind of advantage, being able to show your size with the long free diving fins vertically, is something you always want to try and maintain while you're in the water with the sharks. And never putting your hands out in front or above your head, especially because now you can't really see your hands in relation unless you're looking up to them. So keeping the hands tucked in off the side, onto your camera, one hand here, trying to keep your camera in close for good, more of an arrow-like dive. But again, try to minimize the use of the hands out there and being out and being more in a stealth-like, but always looking around and not creating a lot of splashing on that free dive.
Now, when you do drop down, whether it be vertical in the water column or you did a head-first dive and you're now at depth, turning and rotating from your center, so from your hips, and actually turning around this way so that you're continually scanning your whole perimeter is really, really important, because if you're only looking over your shoulder as you're diving, you're more likely to have blind spots.
Good form is also being slower in the water, more controlled, more relaxed, more confident. If you chase something, and let's say something drops off the side of the boat and you want to get it and there's a lot of sharks, the attention will be at that item that is moving smaller, faster, and there's an energy transfer that happens. So if you do go after that and you move fast, it's gonna change the dynamic. I see it happen all the time. The energy changes, everything starts moving faster, and it turns into more of a hunt. And especially if it was something that you were gonna try and grab, right? So I've seen it happen with pieces of plastic. We wanna pick them up, but we have to kind of like slowly creep towards them, look around, who's paying attention, who's being aware, and then grab it. But if you just dart over and grab it, then they're gonna almost try and beat you to it, thinking that that's something that now you're hunting. You've done a good job of being an equal predator with them, and now they're gonna be competing. You don't wanna compete with them either. So it's super important that when you're going to grab things around sharks, that you're being really aware of the proximity, their interest to that item that you're gonna grab, and then also your approach, the speed. You wanna be slower and selective on those moments that you're gonna grab those items that are in that area, like pieces of plastic when you're cleaning up the ocean around sharks.
Keep your hands close to your body. You're adapting that way. You could potentially use them to help pull yourself down, but wearing extra weight will help you to avoid sculling. So sculling is that movement that a lot of people do when they're underwater. And this is sort of more of the movement of a fish, and it's very eye-catching. And so you don't want to be sculling. So having ample weight and being very graceful or efficient in the water is pretty crucial to being an advanced shark diver. So if you're brand new, really dialing in your free diving, but as you're dialing in your free diving and you're learning to increase your breath hold and your comfort underwater at the same time, don't always follow everything that you're gonna learn in the class as far as just tuck your head down and go one direction. You need to modify and adapt that to sharks and their behavior, especially if you're planning to be in close proximity of them.